Good morning, everyone. Thank you all for coming for what I know will be a very lively and enlightening conversation. The occasion, as you know, is the publication of The Apprentice, Trump, Russia, and the Subversion of American Democracy. Masterfully written by national security reporter Greg Miller in collaboration with his colleagues on the national security, politics, business, and local staffs of the Washington Post. Two of those superb journalists, Alan Nakashima and Craig Timberg, will join with Greg on stage today to talk about the groundbreaking reporting that led first to a Pulitzer Prize for the Washington Post earlier this year, and now have resulted in this book that pulls together the complicated threads of an extraordinary and disturbing story. The stunning intrusion of Russia into an American presidential election with the goal of electing Donald Trump deserved a comprehensive and comprehensible examination. This book provides it. It's a thoroughly absorbing read. Russian interference in an American election, of course, also called for deep journalistic investigation well prior to publication of any book. And the Post did that. It was first on the story, and it has stayed with it hard over the last couple of years. On June 14, 2016, a story by Alan in the Washington Post was the first to reveal that Russian government hackers had penetrated the computer networks of the Democratic National Committee. It was a clear signal, if not fully understood at the time, that the Kremlin had been targeting American political institutions. Nearly 6 months later, in a story also first reported by the Post, Alan Gregg and then colleague Adam Entus wrote that the CIA had concluded in a secret assessment that Russia sought to help Donald Trump win the presidency. The Post's early breakthroughs on the Russia story meant that by the date of Donald Trump's inauguration, our reporters were already speaking to people across the government to understand the Kremlin's role in 2016. The Obama administration's response, and how policy toward Russia would change with the new administration. This running start allowed us to build on Post columnist David Ignatius's revelation on January 12, 2017, that Michael Flynn, then the National Security Advisor designate, and Russian Ambassador Sergei Kislyak had spoken by phone in late December. In early February, Greg, Ellen, and Adam disclosed that the two men had discussed U.S. sanctions against Russia, a story that compelled Flynn's resignation within a week because he had lied in declaring that no such conversation had taken place. From that point, it was on to a year and a half of additional breakthrough reporting about the nature and extent of contacts between Russians and those close to Trump. Revelations that set in motion the appointment of the special counsel. Over the course of the Post investigation, the reporting took many dramatic turns. Greg, for example, became privy to secrets flowing out of the Trump White House, even gaining possession of transcripts of the president's calls with world leaders. His sources enabled him to reveal that Trump had shared highly classified information with Russia's ambassador and foreign minister in a meeting in the Oval Office. Greg went to unusual lengths to protect sources, using code words and even the ruse of a mundane business transaction to provide a plausible explanation for their interactions if ever detected by authorities. A year later, classified memos written by FBI Director James Comey revealed that he and Trump had discussed Greg's story and his sourcing in a chilling Oval Office exchange. "We need to go after the reporters," Trump said, according to Comey's memo. And Trump suggested to Comey that, quote, 10 or 15 years ago, we put them in jail to find out what they know. Now, Comey agreed that the leaks were terrible and said he was, as he put it, eager to find leakers and would like to nail one to the door as a message. There was value, Comey said, in, quote, putting a head on a pike. So fortunately, Greg's head is not on a pike, as you will plainly see. He survived to brilliantly author this book, and I'm proud to now introduce Greg, fellow reporters Ellen Nakashima and Craig Timberg, and an outstanding interviewer, Libby Casey of the Washington Post, who will lead the discussion. Thank you.